Good morning, students. Today we will learn grammar, and the first topic that we will cover today is the sentence. The topics and sentence that we will cover here are: what is a sentence, kinds of sentences, parts of sentence, and phrases. So the first is, what is a sentence? First of all, tell me, if I say sat cat mat on a, can you make a meaning of this sentence? No, we cannot, because these are some words which are not grouped together. These are called jumbled words. These words make no sense until and unless we put them in a proper order. So, and we all know that we need words to speak and to write, to express our feelings. So we can say that a sentence is a group of words that are kept in a particular order to make complete sense. Just having a group of words is not sufficient. We also need to keep them in a proper order. For example, a cat sat on a mat. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. All these words, when put in a particular order, are called sentences. There are four kinds of sentences. Number one is assertive sentence. Number two, interrogative sentence. Number three, imperative sentence. And number four, exclamatory sentence. The first one that comes across is assertive or a declarative sentence. Now we all know that most of the statements that we make to people are some statements. We are saying something to people. So whenever we are saying something, we are telling something, they are called assertive sentences. Here we are not questioning, we are not asking anything, we are not requesting, we are not commanding. Simple sentences, simple statements that we say. For example, the earth revolves around the sun. For example, when we say, I am going to the class tomorrow. I will go to Agra next week. All these are the sentences where we are making statements or are declaring something. So we can say the sentences which make statements or assertions are called declarative or assertive sentences. For example, Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. It is a statement. It is a declaration. Okay. So, the first one that we have learnt is an assertive or a declarative sentence. The next one is an interrogative sentence. Whenever we ask any questions to someone, they are called the interrogative sentences. One of the most basic way of seeing an interrogative sentence is to have a question mark. Whenever there will be words like which, what, when, how, all these words, if they are there in the sentence, then it becomes an interrogative sentence. So look out for these words like what, which, who, when, how, and also look for a question mark. If any of these things are there, it is a question or an interrogative sentence. For example, what is your name? What is COVID-19? The most famous question that is going on right now, because of which we are also staying at home. So all these are interrogative sentence. Also see there are two question marks kept put after the sentence. Okay, so it becomes an interrogative sentence. Number three is an imperative sentence. So imperative sentences are those sentences where we are commanding something or requesting something. So we can say the sentences which express commands or requests are called imperative sentences. For example, be quiet. Here we are commanding the student to be quiet, or to someone. When we are commanding, we are not saying something that we have said and you just hear it from your one ear and take it out from the other one. No, it is a command and you have to follow it. Commands are when someone says and the other person follows it. Okay, so whenever we are commanding, okay, teachers normally command, your parents normally command you. Okay, so these will be These will come under the category of imperative sentence. Be quiet is a imperative sentence, which is a command. Do not run away. So now this is a command which a policeman maybe is saying to a thief. So imperative sentence, command examples I have already given you. Then I can give you an example of requests. Requests are wherever we say please. Please give me a pen. Whenever please will be there, it is a request and it becomes an imperative sentence. Please have mercy on me. Please do complete your work. So these are all imperative sentences. The last kind of sentence is an exclamatory sentence. The sentences which express strong feelings are called exclamatory sentences. We also put an exclamation mark after the exclamatory sentence. For example, how warm the day is. What a shameful behavior. Now, we are expressing our feelings. What a shameful behavior. Whenever you speak these kind of sentences, even your tone has to be changed. Oh, what a shameful behavior. You cannot say it in a plain language like what a shameful behavior. It becomes a statement. No, when an exclamation mark is put, you have to show some feelings, and feelings will be coming the way you will speak, because when we are writing, we cannot show the emotion. Okay, so we put an exclamation mark there to tell the people that it is an exclamation or it is an exclamatory sentence. Just listen carefully. I am reading it once again. It can be read in two ways. If I want to make it a plain statement, I will say, what a shameful behavior. So now here, no feeling can be judged by a person who is listening. If a person is just listening to us, he will not be able to understand whether we are showing any feeling in this sentence or not. So it becomes a simple statement. But when I say, oh, what a shameful behavior, then here I am expressing my feelings through my words, and it is also visible. So here we are putting it an exclamation mark, and it becomes an exclamatory sentence. Okay, the next part that comes across is the parts of sentences. Now we already know that every sentence has got two parts, one subject and the other part is the predicate. Now there is a confusion till class 8th, 9th, till even till 9th. The students normally have a confusion, and they do not know, ma'am. They were last time when I was teaching them, they were asking, ma'am, what is a subject, ma'am, what is a predicate? So here, please understand carefully what is a subject and what is a predicate. When we make a sentence, we name some person or thing, or we say something about that person or thing. Whenever we are saying a sentence, in a sentence we are talking about something or a person. We will not be whatever we are talking about, but we are talking about a person or a thing. So the person or the thing about which we are talking is called the subject, and whatever we talk about that person is called a predicate. As it also says, when we make a sentence, we name some person or thing, or we say something about that person or thing. In other words, we must have a subject to speak about, and we must say something or predicate something about that subject. So the part which names the person or thing we are speaking about is called the subject of the sentence, and the part which tells something about the subject is called the predicate of the sentence. You will understand it better with the examples that are coming. See the examples, subject and the predicate. Very simple sentence with a noun and a verb. We say, Suresh runs. Okay, this is a complete sentence which is having a noun and a verb. Okay, only two words are there. Suresh is the subject about whom we are talking. Suresh. And what is Suresh doing? He is running. So we are talking something about Suresh. So whatever we are talking about Suresh becomes the predicate. Suresh is running or Suresh runs. So runs becomes predicate and Suresh is the subject. Similarly, the second one is birds fly. We are talking about birds, which is a subject. And what are the birds doing? They are flying. So fly becomes the predicate. Number three is girls passed the examination. Whom are we talking about? The girls. The girls becomes the subject. And what are we talking about girls? They have passed the examination. So passed the examination becomes the predicate. My brother, which is a subject, my brother is very good in dance. It is very cold today. The dogs bark at night. Any problem till here, anyone? Okay, I think it is clear. Okay, let us proceed further. Now, there are some, we have already learned what is a subject, what is a predicate, and we have seen some examples also. Subject comes first, predicate comes later. But sometimes the subject can be used in the end also. Yes, it is not necessary that the first word of the sentence will always be the subject. No, it is not necessary. English, we know, is a complicated language. It is not a rule. For example, we can say, here comes the bus. So what are we talking about? We are talking about the bus. The subject here is bus. And what are we talking about the bus? That the bus is coming here. Here comes the bus. That it is coming here. So here comes becomes the predicate of the sentence. Second is, sweet are the uses of adversity. About what is sweet? Okay, so here the noun or the we are talking about adversity. What is adversity? What are okay, sometimes in imperative sentences. What are imperative sentences first? Do you remember? I've just explained you. Yes, the requests or the commands. So sometimes in the imperative sentences, the subject is left out. For example, when I say sit down. Sit down is just a command. Whom are we saying to? Sit down. To the class. The class sit down. You sit down. So there is no subject here. But here it is understood that the person is saying it to you. So you is a subject here, which is understood. Thank him. Who to thank him? You have to thank him. So you is understood. So whenever in an imperative sentence, the subject is not written, it is understood according to the sentence. Next is, what is a phrase? Now, phrase is also one of the very confusing topics for the students. Okay, till class 8th, they were having a confusion. Ma'am, what is a phrase? Ma'am, what is a sentence? How are we going to differentiate between it? So, here, a group of words which make sense but not complete sense is called a phrase. They usually do not have a subject or the predicate. They are just group of words which are making sense, but we cannot understand properly what is the person going to say. For example, bed of roses. Yes, there is a bed of roses that we can understand. But what is the bed of roses here for? For whom is it there? What will you do of it? We cannot understand anything about it. So, it becomes a phrase. Rises in the east. What rises in the east? If we say the sun rises in the east, yes, it is understood. But without the subject, rises in the east has no meaning of its own. So it becomes a phrase. Of great beauty. Of great beauty what? We cannot understand. So it also becomes a phrase of the sentence. Okay, so now we have finished about what is sentences, what are the kinds of sentences, and what are the parts of sentences. So here are some exercises that we will quickly do. You will be doing the exercises with me, and you will answer it along with me, and then I will also tell you the answers. First is, separate the subject and predicate in the following sentences. The boy stood on the last bench. What is the subject here? Yes. Yes, the boy is the subject and stood on the last bench is the predicate. Second, it is very hot. The subject is it and is very hot is the predicate. Very good. The third is the cow gives us milk. So here the subject is the cow and the predicate is gives us milk. The earth revolves around the sun. Subject here is the earth and revolves around the sun is the predicate. The last one is we cannot make the ocean dry. So we is the subject and cannot make the ocean dry is the predicate. Okay, how many of you did all the answers correct? Very good. Those who have not done all the answers correct, I would like you to go and see the video again and then attempt the exercise again. We have one more exercise though. You have to name the type of sentences. The first one is please let me work. Here it is please here, so it is a request. Whenever it is a request, what kind of a sentence is it? Yes, it is an imperative sentence. The boys make a noise. This is a statement. Someone is telling someone about the boys. So it is a statement, so it becomes the assertive or the declarative sentence. Stand up is a command, so it becomes an imperative sentence. What a clever girl you are. Oh yes, this is so simple. Exclamation mark is there. Yes, an exclamation mark is there, so it becomes an exclamatory sentence. What a horrible sight it was. See, some people were confused one day. They said, ma'am, because here it is what is also written, so it is a question. If there was a question mark, it would become a interrogative sentence. But here, because there is an exclamation mark, it is a exclamatory sentence. Okay, and read the sentence also correctly. She is not asking a question. What a clever girl you are. She is not asking what kind of a girl you are. If she had asked what kind of a girl you are, it would have been a question. But she is already answering herself. So what a clever girl you are is always, even if there is no question mark and even if you are asked to do a punctuation, see here there is no question. You can read the question and understand. There is no question. So it is always an exclamatory sentence. So it is always an exclamatory sentence here. What a horrible sight it was. Again, it is an exclamatory sentence. Where do you live is an interrogative sentence. Who is at the door? Interrogative sentence. And children like sweets. Okay, so we have completed the chapter. Thank you. If you have understood and answered all the exercises carefully, it is very good. Otherwise, see the video again and do some exercises. Thank you.